I'm so excited to see you this week. I'm going to tell you about three men who had kind of funny names in the Bible. Their names were Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Kind of funny, huh? Let me tell you the story. So they grew up in Judah, and Babylon, another country, invaded them and took them as captives. They kidnapped them. And they wanted those three men because they were really, really smart. And they wanted good leaders in Babylon, so they took those men over to Babylon and made them, forced them to be part of the leadership. But despite the fact that they weren't in their home country, they weren't with their families, they were all alone in a new environment, they still chose to obey God. Let me tell you what happened. So there was a king who also had a funny name. His name was Nebuchadnezzar, and he was really interested in himself. He thought he was awesome. And so he built a huge statue of himself. It was as tall as a huge building. And he called all the important leaders of the land to come and see this statue. And while they were there, the king's men announced that everybody had to bow down and worship the statue. When the music started, they had to bow down and worship the statue. Well, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego only worshiped the one true God. They did not want to bow down and worship. But the king said if they didn't, they would be thrown into a fiery furnace. That's a really hard decision. What would you do? Let me tell you what Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego did. When that music started to play, they kept standing. They did not bow down and worship that statue. They only wanted to worship the one true God. Well, some people who did not like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego went to the king and told him exactly what happened, that Shadrach and Meshach and Abednego did not bow down. So the king summoned them right away, and he was furious. He yelled at them and told them, "I'm going to give you one more chance to worship this statue. When the music plays, you must bow down and worship." Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego said, "We don't need a second chance, king. No matter what you do, we will not bow down. Even if we have to die, we know our God will rescue us, but even if he doesn't, we will never bow down and worship it." Well, the king got so angry, he told the people in charge of the fiery furnace to heat it 7 times hotter than it already was. He had his guards take Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, tie them up, and throw them into the flames. It was so hot that the guards that threw Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego into the flames died because they got too close to the fire. The king was watching this whole time, and all of a sudden he looked and he said to his counselors, "Didn't we throw 3 men into the fire? Why do I see 4? The counselors were just confused, and they said, "We have no idea. You put in 3 men. The king said, "Tell them to come out." And so Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came out. And when they came out of that fire, they didn't smell like smoke. They didn't have 1 singed hair on their body. And their clothes weren't burnt at all. It was a miracle. God had sent, some people say maybe it was Jesus or an angel, to protect them in that fire. And when King Nebuchadnezzar saw that, he said, "There is only one true God, and that's your God. I will never, ever force you to bow down and worship anyone else." I was just so happy to, when I read this story, I've heard this story lots of times, but I was just reminded about how good and faithful our God is, how he protects us, how he helps us to do the right thing. It's just so exciting to know that we're never alone. He's always with us. Let's pray this week. Father, thank you that you keep us safe. Thank you that you help us to do the right thing, even when it's hard. God, we love you. We praise you because you are so faithful. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Friends, I love you. Have a great week. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.